And the obligatory tweet to Airmech because of that. So if you can let me know if my volume levels are okay on the stream. Like, is the music really loud and stuff? Can you hear me talking? And all that crap. That would be lovely because I don't remember if my volume levels were good or whatnot before.
You are staring at Beck and Chet.
Oh, son of a bitch. Good. Nice. Thank you. That is important.
That lagging is like pretty a mofo.
I'm lagging? But let me spec something. Tell me if it looks okay. Plugging. I see. Oh, let me turn mumble. My text to speech off. I'll turn that off. So let me just look for another. Refresh. Whoa, what's with that lag? Damn. Okay. Let's see here.
Keep your Steam chat somewhere, like on
another. Keep my Steam chat what?
Keep your Steam chat somewhere else, like on another screen, so I can talk to you, because I would probably want
sure,
to
sure.
Mic.
Sure, sure.
Alright,
I'm doing
turning
that.
Turning off mic.
If I don't respond, you gotta put, like, extremely noticeable characters, like, go like this. Something like that, because I get very distracted. Something like that. Not exactly. Okay, let's check my lag real quick. Oh, here's a 2v2! Oh, not a 2v2, a 1v1. Wow, I saw 2/2, and I just, in my head, I was like, 2v2. So, volume levels. If anybody wants to let me know if the volume levels, like, is the music loud? Can you hear it? Should I turn it up? Should I turn it down? All that stuff. I typically try to pause my music if I'm watching something. It's a 2-star elo though. In a 1v1 is actually pretty high. I like, if you're gonna watch a 1v1, a 1-star is kind of appropriate. 2-stars, a 2-star level elo is actually kind of hard to get. In 1v1. Not hard, but not easy. So. Hey dude, what's up? I really don't like Twitch. The stupid the viewers list just doesn't update properly. You have to like close and open it manually. And it's like, come on, man. Twitch. Come on, Twitch. Come on, Twitch. So yeah, I'm going to see if I can find a 2-star Mavericks game. Just going to spectate something pretty high level and high action real quick. Okay, or not, because the game says screw you. So let's look at a hyper ultimate game. Why the hell not? Sanguinius is in this one. And just happens. Oh, it's a 3v3 immediately. So, am I lagging, guys? Am I okay? I'm trying to see. Maybe I haven't streamed for like a long time. So, I just want to see if my settings are okay and all that stuff. I didn't feel like doing test ones just now just because I'm really lazy. So, if the lag is okay and all that, is it really crappy looking? I'm okay. All right. As long as I'm okay, I don't really need crystal clear stuff. I don't have. And what about the volume levels for the music? Yeah. Right now, that is the rock, the main theme song from the movie The Rock, because that movie is awesome. All right, cool. Thanks, guys. Really does help because I can't really view my own stream. Like, I don't have like another computer set up to do that. You know what I mean? Like, there's problems. There's problems. It does cause problems sometimes. All right, so do you guys know that global chat pauses while you're spectating a game? Yeah, I'm not really sure exactly why they made that happen, but all right. So guys, I have a big dashboard, yeah, but then I literally would hear my own stuff and my stream, and then it would echo, and then it would be all crazy and stupid. So yeah. So guys, I'm trying to look for another 2-star Mavericks game. Turn that down just a little bit. Oh, thanks, Fires. There, Fire 567. That's cool, man. Thank you for the follow. I don't really stream too much. I mostly do YouTube, so. But right now, I just felt like streaming because Bonjibon bothers me and he tells me to do it. So, I have if you look at my video, oh crap, I don't even know. Look at my channel description. Do I have my information? I don't even know. I don't know if I have my information in there. I think I do. I'm pretty sure I do. I have a link to it. Okay, thank God. Oh. Yeah, I just do not stream enough. So, oh, dude, you are in a game with Sire and Echo Spawn, huh? Against Chimney Fan and Happy Cammer too. So I don't think that's really gonna be, you know, the most balanced of games, and all that stuff. So, guys, if you don't know, if anyone's watching and does not know, I do this series called 2-Star Mavericks. I probably should have named it 1-Star Mavericks in hindsight, just because Husky names his Bronze League heroes, but yeah, whatever. It's still an okay name. It kind of represents the actual skill level of games I'm kind of trying to look for, which is borderline 1 and 2 star, because it at that point you're kind of like, you know what you're doing, but you don't really know what you're doing. So that's why I like 2-star Mavericks, like, you know, borderline 1 and 2 star games. So let's see, let me try to find I'm gonna give this one a shot. This is a little insight, guys. So how much elo is needed for 1, 2, 3? This is what I've guessed just by looking, right? I'm pretty sure it's give or take, and I think the dev said it at one point. 3-star is 1900 plus ish, right? 1-star is 1700 below, and 2-star is 17 to 19. So I don't feel like typing that out right now, if you guys heard that. So let's give this a shot. I'm going to pause my music right now. All right, here we go. This is an attempt at finding a 2-star Mavericks game, and we are on Chasm. This was a 2-star ELO game, but in 1v1, 2-star does not necessarily mean noob. However, we do have WordPad here in the upper left-hand corner as the blue player on Chasm. He has no money makers. This is not Salt, ladies and gentlemen. This is a normal PvP game in the current live patch, which is 1.9.1.3.4, and he is going only levelers. So this is possibly OP. It is possibly a train wreck. Let's see what. Oh, and speaking of train, Woot, we do have a fat line of Dillos right here. That is a full build queue full of Dillos, and he is stopping at a build queue full of Dillos at 5 right there. The game is about to start. We do have ZZI Carnage ZZ, who will now from now on be known as Carnage, because God, I'm not going to say all those letters, and he is the red player in the bottom right hand corner in the Chrome Saucer, doing a quick scout for the bottom. Does see nothing on that bottom, but doesn't decide to harass it at all, going for the fort, which is pretty well protected, and WordPad is there, so missed opportunity, a leveler all by itself down there at the bottom, but not going for that attack down there at the bottom, instead going for the fort, which is quite the ballsy decision. And now does WordPad, you saw him attacking the entire time. Why didn't you, oh man, why didn't you try to kill him? And Carnage, not being contested at all, stopping his harass, not going to respond to WordPad quite. Okay, now he is responding to WordPad's attack up here. Needs to kill one of those infantry, but attacking WordPad instead. WordPad is going to be able to get this. No. Does WordPad have anything in his build queue? He has a single Dillo and a soldier. He bunkers the soldier, which I guess is the correct decision now. Instead of queuing up more defensive units, he is going just more bunkered soldiers. Queuing up one thing at a time. He doesn't have multiple things in his build queue. Might as well be using the old Natasha with 3 build queue max. But Carnage is actually pushing out with 2 of the Dillos. Why not the rest of the Dillos? Oh, because the rest of the Dillos went over here or something? I was not paying attention, and to be honest, who cares? has one seeker and two dillos over here, but WordPad and this is not Salt Mechanics, ladies and gentlemen. These dillos will go down pretty quick, especially to a hog with dillos and Bucky's in support. So ZZI Carnage, ZZ, I did say again, but that will be the last time. Carnage is not really going to be super successful here, going with Death Ray first, which is pretty popular, and WordPad already level 4 has two points into guns and 1 point in air to ground. Nothing into spin up, but almost getting. Oh, will we be able to finish off ZZ Carnage? Okay, no, almost getting Carnage. There, very close. Holy crap, that was close. But now WordPad. The day when a hog kills a saucer in the air. Well, I guess that's the day you're watching Two Star Mavericks, right? So yeah, that's what the next thing that happens. And ZZI Carnage, I to be honest, I didn't even take a look at the loadouts at all. If you could see me, which I'm not webcamming ever, but I had my hands thrown up just now because I don't care. I did not care looking at those loadouts. But he does have a couple shooters coming out. They will stop right about here to shoot at whatever units that WordPad has. But as a hog, we'll be able to kill that extremely quickly. And ZZI Carnage. I just can't help but saying that entire name just because it's absurdly ridiculous with too many letters at the beginning. But WordPad doing a really good job killing some stuff here. I mean, really good job is a little bit of a stretch. Killing creeps with air to ground is not necessarily the highest level of play, but he was actually able to kill those creeps. So I guess he didn't die to them, so that's a good thing. Bucky coming out, and WordPad killing ZZI Carnage. ZZ sleeping I Carnage, I guess. And so that saucer did finally get killed by the hog in the air, not blinking away, because guess what? He doesn't have blink. And he does, however, he does have 28,000 credits in his build, in his bank right now, and now queuing up Seekers and Dillos, but sending them already without waiting for the rest of his stuff to come out. So WordPad will be able to pick these off one at a time, coming in as a level 6 hog with level 3 guns. Okay, but WordPad, you had a post right there. WordPad, come on, man. Maybe he needs to upgrade to Microsoft Word instead of just WordPad, which comes free with Windows every single time that you install Windows. FYI, guys, if you do have a Microsoft Word formatted document, WordPad can open it and view it. Not properly, it won't look exactly like it will on Word, but if you just need that information, oh, and WordPad getting killed in the air there. But yeah, if you just need that information, WordPad will do the job. Might as well talk about that, since I don't really have anything else to talk about right now, because they are just waiting on stuff to build, and ZZI not scouting, he's just waiting. WordPad is dead. His opportunity, huge window of opportunity right now. Completely unguarded, number one. Completely unguarded, number two. Sitting here, just chilling, waiting for his dillos to come out, making sure that WordPad doesn't magically come back, teleport here, and neutralize his outpost immediately, which is a concern sometimes. You know, every once in a while. Sure. Maybe in StarCraft or something. Okay, but yeah, WordPad coming with 4 creeps. He was building soldiers that entire time, but this time comes... Oh, no! My bad. 2 creeps and 2 soldiers. Once again, something I've never seen here on Two Star Mavericks. Is able to neutralize his outpost, but WordPad taking a, you know, getting blocked by that outpost, and ZZI not... Oh, God, WordPad had no life left, but... God, he survived! He had 0 life left. Carnage just had to land and kill him. And WordPad was able to survive this entire thing. Needs to kill off that Dillo first. The Dillo's gonna neutralize that outpost. WordPad, kill it first. The Seeker is not a threat. Kill the Dillo first, but now ZZI Carnage with a lot of creeps and brings a Seeker as well. So mixing it up, ground attacking, air attacking, why not? Carnage almost able to kill WordPad there with that Death Ray on the ground, but thank God he has one into Blink. He does have one into Blink. I don't even know if he's using it. Let's see if he is using it. I don't really care what WordPad is doing right now. He's definitely going to be able to... Okay, definitely is a strong word. He might be able to keep this outpost. Creeps shooting in. WordPad, defensive infantry coming down. We'll be able to retake this unless those creeps actually... Nope. Creeps not able to wander in fast enough. This does go back up to WordPad, and ZZI Carnage with Seeker spam really wants to kill WordPad, I guess. Either that or is not really completely sure what those Seekers actually do. Maybe he's under the impression that they might be good at neutralizing that outpost. If he is, he would be completely wrong. And WordPad just making infantry now to keep this outpost under his control, which I think, at this point, to be honest, is probably a good decision because there's nothing but Seekers coming out. So all he has to do is just... This is exactly what WordPad needs to do. Use air to ground. I would never have said that before, but right now in this specific situation, which I've never ever seen in my entire life, This is what he needs to do. Use air to ground. There's nothing threatening on the ground right now. And Jesus Christ, he the more air to ground he uses, the safer he will be, because he will be able to survive that Seeker attack from the cover of his own outpost. Now that Sam is in danger, it has those defensive infantry in queue. He needs to bring the infantry out of his queue! Bring the infantry out of his queue! Okay, thank God the Sam is not able to neutralize it completely. Oh man, I might have a migraine here. And right now, WordPad, already level 9, has a Goliath coming out, already out, and now a Dillo finally come out from Carnage, just sending a single unit at a time. Guys, two-star Mavericks, stop it, please, God, stop it. Carnage is able to neutralize his outpost, but once again, WordPad, with exactly 4 infantry coming out, is able to retake this outpost. These guys are the new MLG status right now. Use exactly the amount of infantry that you need to take an outpost. No extra, because playing it safe is for little bitches. First time I've actually cursed on air, I think. Depending on what you call a curse word. But yes, now Carnage coming out with more Seekers, and I'm getting a little lazy here. I'm not using mouse click at all. Need to make sure that outpost is under focus. And WordPad bringing those infantry just in time to keep Carnage from taking this back under his control. Will be able to kill the Seeker unless Carnage with that death rate. No, WordPad lift off just in time. Nothing in his build queue quite yet. Now coming back to wait for soldiers. So maybe he needed to queue them up beforehand. But what the hell do I know? I'm just here to I'm here to speculate. That's pretty much what I'm doing right now. Speculating. And making sure that everyone has doubts. You know what I'm saying? I might be right, I might be wrong, but doubts are what I need to put into your mind right now. And Carnage not bringing infantry, and WordPad doing exactly, dropping it on the pretty much the exact side he needs to. Oh, getting killed by those Seekers before he's able to survive long enough to heal up on that outpost that he just took. So Carnage will be able to neutralize this with these creeps. There's only 3 though, so he does need to get one more. Carnage, why are you only queuing up Seekers, man? And he's in, and the funny thing is he's positioning the Seekers such that they'll probably hit the outpost if WordPad is above it, even if he doesn't even have it in his control. But WordPad with more Seekers and repositioning the goalie, thank God, now to kill those Seekers, so that goalie will be able to eventually kill those Seekers. Probably could have just dropped it right there in the midst of all those Seekers, but why the hell not just drop it on the side where Carnage will have an easy time to micro them away, and he is doing just that one at a time. One single one at a time, only level 4, so definitely is not, you know, has, definitely does not have enough level to actually carry 2. He doesn't have any boosters, but WordPad, how is he taking this outpost over and over again? What is happening? How is he doing this? He's taking it over and over again, and it's definitely due to Carnage only spamming Seekers, and look at his build queue. Well, once again, only has Seekers in his build queue, just losing them over and over to WordPad's air to ground. I don't know if I expected to ever say that in my life. Losing them over and over to air to ground, but it is happening right now. WordPad air grounding like a boss. It does not bring those infantry out of his queue quick enough to keep this outpost under his control. And now Carnage with 3 bulbs up left. 3 infantry seems to be the theme of this entire thing for Carnage, because he does not have any creeps coming in. Creep, go back. You will help your mech master if you come back. Nope. Okay. Well, you know, just you suck. And oh, that Goliath able to delight that bulb just in time. WordPad, where are you going? WordPad going all the way back to that back factory to grab one soldier out of his build queue. But once he comes back here, we'll be able to bring another goalie out of his build queue. Carnage, so many Seekers. And here's the thing. I'm going to say it again, in like too close to this stupid outpost, and so every time they try to attack WordPad, they're hitting the outpost instead. Carnage, spread out your Seekers. Okay, Carnage is able to neutralize this outpost again. Like, I didn't see that one coming, because the theme of this entire match is this power station right here going up and down from color to color to color, getting neutralized, and WordPad bringing exactly 4 infantry every single time and neutralizing it. I mean, it brings a new definition to Deja Vu. With Goliath out on the field, Carnage does not decide to put any points into abducting. He's trying to abduct Goliaths. Oh, and he finally does put 1 point into abduct. Okay, come on, man. You gotta abduct the Goliaths. Oh, but he's not level 5. Oh, God. I didn't even think about that. He's only level 5, not level 7, so these Goliaths are 2 levels away from his control. Oh, so sad. Sad day. Sad day for Carnage here. Like, that was a great plan. He realized, oh, I can abduct these Goliaths, but he's two levels away, and these Goliaths are just going to wreak havoc here. WordPad, he's just living on the edge here. Look, there's like three bars of health, but lifts off just in time. Oh my god, that was so pro! Lifts off just in time to avoid that death ray and air to ground, killing Carnage on the ground. Oh my god, this is so epic. Holy crap, this is so epic. Now with four more infantry coming out, and he's going to be able to get this. With four infantry, once again, surprise, surprise, body block, yes, does body block for those infantry and kill the creeps coming in. That one Dillo did get killed by the Goliath. Oh my god, was that Goliath put on patrol? What? And he's doing it again. He's putting Goliaths on patrol. Guys, he's putting Goliaths on patrol. And Carnage now going straight for the fort attack. Will FF, or not word, FF, word pad, will he be able to... Why are you attacking the leveler? Leveler's not doing him anything anymore. He's level 12. He's okay. And what? They're just doing their own things on opposite sides of the map. And Carnage, not even death raying, with a full bar of energy, shoot the fort! Ah! And WordPad is completely ignoring it. Has goalies coming there. Okay, now coming back. And this Goliath will come. Yeah, just nothing defending over here. WordPad coming back here to take care of Carnage. And Carnage not repositioning those Dillos. Neither did to reposition the Dillos. Would have caused a lot of trouble for WordPad. Now WordPad coming up with busters. Oh, I didn't even notice WordPad had busters in his loadout. And once again, Carnage trying to abduct goalies at level 5. Build more stuff. You have 86,000. Block with the Dillos. Block with the Dillos. Please, God, block with the Dillos. No, WordPad's gonna be able to shoot your fort. You're like a third of life is a third of your life is gone. No, block. Don't shoot. Put him in the back. Block. He's in the block. You're screwed. You're gonna die. And WordPad might actually even be able to kill Carnage on the ground with his air to ground again. Once again, oh, getting that epic level up. Though both the Dillos have been killed, or the Dillos, both the Goliaths have been killed in Carnage. Oh god, this is so exhausting. WordPad now coming out with more goalies, putting on patrol, guys. Okay. Okay, so whatever. Carnage drops another Dillo here. Front door wide open, but decides to put it on the side because front door is once again four little pussies. And now WordPad gonna come out with more Goliaths, and okay, now sets that other one. Okay, now has three Goliaths and a Buster coming for Carnage's fort. Oh my god, Carnage, you are one level away from being able to abduct those Goliaths. You have 92,000 credits. Build more stuff, please God, build more stuff. You have plus 63 power, you will be completely fine, but instead decides to death ray these goalies to death, and they will... Oh god, this is actually the right decision. He should be death raying these goalies from behind because they are spread out and WordPad is not there. So that was the right decision. Sadly, that was the right decision to death ray the stuff from behind. He doesn't have level 7 yet, so he can't abduct those goalies. And able to finish off those goalies before they ever reach the fort. WordPad almost killed. No, you gotta lift off and kill WordPad before he gets... Never mind. And now, once again, WordPad sending stuff, putting stuff down on patrol. Oh, where did that goalie come from? It came from Ish here, so maybe it came from, like, all the way... I don't know. I have no idea where it came from. But now WordPad trying to defend his goalie by body blocking the death ray. Does grab it in time, but oh my god, he's gonna die in the air. No, does turn and burn just in time. And now Carnage, level 7! No, Carnage, you can abduct it! You can finally do it. You can finally do it. However, with pretty much 97,000, like pretty much 100k in his bank right now. WordPad going to no. You can abduct. You can abduct it. Come on. You've been doing it the entire game. You can do it now. You can do it now. Okay. Oh god. Oh, migraine coming. Okay. So now WordPad is losing units left and right. Carnage doing the exact same thing. Units left and right being lost, and now actually making his way to the fort once again. No, just drop it at that outpost. You can neutralize it. You can. Oh god, and we have another Goliath on patrol around the fort. Oh god, so many firsts. It's Goliaths on patrol. I have never seen that. I mean, once again, two-star Mavericks is probably where meta ideas happen. Not necessarily meta developing, but meta ideas happening here on two-star Mavericks. Carnage able to kill that Ratchet with his death ray. Might probably be able to kill this patrolling Goliath with his death ray as well. WordPad does catch him before he actually is able to finish it off. And WordPad with nothing defending here except for a Goliath. And Morgulad's coming out. He does have Dillos still. He can spam those for defense. You need to put that Goliath right there in the front. Those level 4 creeps are really going to just wreak havoc on your outposts. Okay, does drop. Okay, a second Goliath goes down. And defensive infantry, so WordPad definitely knows what he's doing in that regard. And Carnage does retreat here. Okay, and WordPad now does have a completely full bulbed outpost. And now queuing up hats. Queuing up hats. What are you doing? Guy, hats is not what you need right now. Just make more goalies and send them out against Carnage. I guess the hats can defend against the abduct, which Carnage is not doing. Okay, now now has Goliaths coming out and not leapfrogging at all. Just making a clump right here, right there is where the clump is happening. So I guess, sure, but now WordPad has some Goliaths, or not Goliaths, some hats on the field. You can put them in the sockets and that will be pretty much the exact same thing. Hats just got their range reduced, actually, along with Flackers. In the most recent balance patch, but now Carnage with a Goliath coming out of the not on WordPad's radar. Check that out. So okay, now finally on WordPad's radar. But I if WordPad notices this, then something wrong is happening. Okay, now does drop that Goliath on attack over here. Let's see what it will encounter. Two Goliaths. Carnage, you just needed to bring it a little bit further. Drop it on that front door. Forget it. They can't hear me. Okay, and WordPad finishing off Carnage once again in the air. That saucer not getting away. I don't know if he realizes he has Blink, but he is not really using it to the extent that he needs to, if he is. So now Carnage, again, death raying the Goliaths that he can probably abduct now. And I guess that hat is there. Okay, now WordPad leapfrogging that hat, which is going to be pretty effective if he has defending Goliaths there. But no, just brings more hats. Needs to put those Goliaths there in defensive position. Now, that first hat did get killed pretty damn quick by those Dillos. That second hat wasn't even being fired on because I think the land would have been able to block it. But now the land, meaning the difference in elevation on the land. Carnage finishing off that second goalie. Oh man, what is happening here? If to be honest, the weird thing here is, in my opinion, if these guys played the meta at this point that everyone hates, the turtle meta, either of them could win against the other if the other one didn't do the same thing, to be honest. So WordPad is kind of actually doing that. Has a lot of units here. He can easily take that back, this outpost. I don't know if he realizes it, but WordPad was able to actually grab this because the neutrals on that side were not killed. I guess that's Goliath. Probably that one Goliath that was sent over here did not really get did not really get too much damage in against two other Goliaths. But now Carnage leapfrogging instead of sending. There are so many Goliaths and Dillos over here sitting over here for him, so I guess he probably doesn't realize that, yeah, a push against a single Goliath and a couple of hats will definitely work. But now Carnage with one. Why did you bring one creep? Why did you bring one creep? Guys, don't do that. One creep. Creeps come out in waves, in packs. I think on Chasm they come out in five. At quarter four, you would have been able to grab three. One creep. It's not gonna is one creep an attack does not make. Okay, so don't do that anymore, please. Carnage, send, please. Carnage, WordPad has significantly less money makers than, okay, significantly less. He has zero. So whatever many money makers you have on the field, you are owning. Come on, Carnage, send. Put more than just anti-air on the front of the factory to defend. Put the Dillos, okay, just rotate. Like, if you took this and rotated it just a little bit, and this Dillo was here and this Dillo was here, that would be better. But you're not doing that, so all your stuff is getting, okay. Carnage killing WordPad again, so what the hell do I know? I guess whatever he's doing is doing something right. Oh my god, a creep has made it all the way to the fort, but now turning around because this is the outpost that it's going to go for. And now instead of pushing out, once again, Carnage coming with a Seeker. He's dropping a Seeker and leaving it by itself. He's dropping a Seeker and leaving it by itself right there at the outpost. What is he bringing? Another Seeker. Oh, Jesus. Oh, Lord Almighty. WordPad will be able to finish off these two as a level 15 hog. Those were just free Seekers, but by themselves. Seekers dropped by themselves over here. Oh, I mean, you wanted to see something, guys. That was it. WordPad now supporting his own creeps over here, attacking this outpost. Probably would be able to neutralize and take it if he dedicates his time. So bringing more creeps, where is he bringing them? God, I was about to say, please God, not the fort. Bring them to that outpost. But now they will walk away. WordPad gonna shoot into. Oh, killing a. Nope, kill not gonna kill the moneymakers because a, at this point, killing moneymakers will be negligible, to be honest, against Carnage right now with so much more income and money. But WordPad has those creeps coming in, and they will not be dealt with very easily by just this AA. Only this one Dillo will be shooting at these creeps and these creeps as well. So let's see how much havoc WordPad is going to be able to wreak here on Carnage. Carnage trying to reposition these Dillo, these Goliaths. Funnily enough, Carnage has all the Seekers everywhere but where he needs them, here at the fort. Now dropping Seekers finally in for that fort protection, so WordPad can't do any harass, but oh my god, look how much life he has left. He has about a third of his life left, and now this outpost was neutralized, and WordPad was able to grab it. Now Carnage, where is he going? Where is he going? Front door, just front door, death ray, front door, death ray. You're at that, yes, thank god, yes, Carnage, yes. Oh, and right now WordPad is not coming back to respond. Carnage might actually be able to get this win. No, oh god, no, oh god, no. No! Okay, the patrolling Goliath is coming around, and WordPad is not going to be able to actually push. I mean, look at this. He's definitely not going to be able to push out. He might be able to drop this goalie at the front door. It will take forever, but is Carnage going to be able to grab this? Oh my god, is he going to be able to win? He needs to avoid that Goliath fire. As a saucer on the ground, will definitely be able to do it. WordPad now here with a Goliath at the front door. Oh my god, this is the weirdest best base race I've ever seen. WordPad getting finished off by those Seekers and the Dillo, and the two Goliaths are here at the front door. Oh no, Carnage is coming back. He's coming back. Needs to block some. No, dropping it. Block, please God, block. No. Oh, I didn't block. Oh, I didn't block. Oh, my heart. Oh, my heart. Oh, God. Oh, my heart. Okay. WordPad. WordPad has left the game. And Carnage, ZZI, Carnage ZZ, taking the defeat here against WordPad in this two-star Mavericks, which, oh god, the game froze. The game froze, so I don't know if you guys can see anything, but my game froze. But Twitch is still broadcasting me, so I will do my quick closing right now. So if you guys want to send me any two-star Mavericks, send them in to me at ruyzerx@gmail.com or RUY on Steam. Oh man, what has frozen? Has OBS frozen? I don't know. Okay, but oh god, okay, close. Okay, so this will be a black screen. Okay, this will be a black screen thing right there. But yeah, okay, if you guys want to send me any two-star Mavericks replays, you will be rewarded by a donut code. And not the crappy donuts that were in Crate 2, but the cool donuts, I will redeem my quest now, but the cool donuts that are just the round ones. I'm going to give you a quick example of that here. Because all this bandwidth is free for me, donut. Okay, so these donuts, you're not going to get those from my donut codes. If you send me a two-star Maverick replay that is actually good, that I will use, that is funny, that I can use on my channel, you will get one of these expensive donuts that people are selling off for give or take 4,000 to 5,000 diamonds right now. So, yes, check my video description, which is not in this Twitch broadcast, but I will be able to put that in my video description on my YouTube channel. But yes, check that video description, click that link for details on how to send me replays for two-star Mavericks. This is RUY, and that is game. See you next time. Okay, guys, so that was ridiculous. Is my stream still going? I don't even know. Is my stream still going? The game froze, and like, my volume mixer kind of freaked out because the game was frozen. But yeah, okay, I think the game... Okay, so my stream is going. I'm going to put my main title for Star Wars music back up. I'm going to grab some water, which I'm out of, and I will be right back. BRB, anyway. FYI, FBRB. That's what I'm doing. I think muting my mic on stream did nothing, because I'm also still broadcasting through Mumble. I'm stupid. But anyway. Yeah, man, my voice is kind of shot after that, man. My throat. Just all that screaming. Pretty much screaming. The entire time. So, guys, if you want to suggest which game I should actually watch instead of just choosing one or something, then that would be great. There's a bunch on the watch tab right now. So, oh, it was muted? Okay. Cool. That would have been kind of embarrassing. Oh, yeah, I'll do that. Hey, Tipsy. What's up, man? You are live on stream right now, FYI. Yes. I'm in the streaming room. Oh God. Okay. Oh hey, there's a Turtleton. Against the same guy. Wait, what? I'm not paying attention, so. Okay. So if anybody on stream wants to what's it called? Suggest something. Wait, can you guys not hear my mumble? Yeah, I don't know if people on stream can hear. I once again did not really do my volume levels and check stuff. Oh, they only hear me. They only hear me, apparently. Crap. Why is that? I'm pretty sure I thought it broadcasts all my Windows 7 sounds. That's pretty strange. That's a good freaking question. I'm using OBS, but let me see. Audio. I mean, it's playing my music and the game sounds, right? So, I don't have like my Winamp on stream thing. That's okay. I'll troubleshoot that later. They don't need to hear you because why the hell? Why would they? So, I am using a headset mic. Yeah. I thought so. Yeah, so that's why I'm confused why they can't hear the mumble, because my Windows sounds are pretty much open. I thought that's what it's broadcasting, but whatever. Anyways, so I'll do my best to ignore you. And so let's see. We do have another game with Turtleton. Is this what you guys want to see? Turtleton? With the same guy, ZZI Carnage, I will get my music paused real quick. If that you guys didn't know that was the Batman original movie from the 90s theme. Either 90s or late 80s, I just don't remember exactly. So, let's go into this spec here. Okay, alright, here we go, guys. Oh, this is another 2-star Mavericks, I think. Against, it's going to be between Turtleton. I don't know where that name was inspired from. Possibly he's a tortoise fan or something like that. And ZZI Carnage. And Turtleton definitely looks like he kind of knows what he's doing. He has a lockbox down, not a safe box. So that's not... I don't know exactly if the 1v1 meta has shifted to lockbox, but that's what he has down on the field right now. We do have ZZI Carnage, the same guy from the last game, with full Moneymaker build. He does have a few Dillos out on the field going straight for the bottom, so not playing exactly what is considered the standard right now, which is going straight for top, and Turtleton just sitting there, turtling above his outpost. I guess namesake is pretty... Okay, and now we do have ZZI Carnage with a front door attack straight. he's just going for the ratchet. Why are you attacking the ratchet? Okay, and Turtleton putting some zippers down and blocking position, three zippers down, none of them were able to block that Dillo, and Turtleton trying to attack ZZI Carnage from the ground while he's in the air, and will be able to finish off him, kind of missing that Dillo at first, and ZZI trying to body block for that Dillo, not going to be able to save it. Now Turtleton finally able to actually kill that Dillo off, not before he loses a, I don't know, the 15th or 20th or something like that of his health, and now walling up with zippers. Oh, man. You know, when they say there's a first time for everything, and I always say that kind of thing in Two Star Mavericks, I never really fully expect it. We did have a couple of zippers drop down here by Turtleton, but I didn't really pay attention to that, and who cares, it's back. But yeah, now he's starting to wall up with zippers. Once again, never seen that before, and now Turtleton front-dooring with a saucer. I'm biting my fingers right now because he's front-dooring with a saucer. Okay, so right now, ZZR Carnage setting up an Archie, and we'll be able to attack some of these neutrals over here, and Turtleton dropping immediately. Oh, had four soldiers in his build queue, in his cargo, so he might be able to actually neutralize this outpost, but splitting his attention, going with his mech against that Archie and the infantry attacking the outpost. Not going to get too far. You need to really focus on your purpose there. Now Turtleton with four infantry, four soldiers in his build queue, now bringing them once again, trying to cheese this this close outpost of ZZR Carnage, and Carnage now just again, oh, whoa, where the hell did the camera go there? But yeah, Carnage just dropping an Archie over there. This does get neutralized, but Turtleton not able to grab this quite yet. And God, I thought this was a Smurf. He's not playing like a Smurf. Oh, jeez. Okay, but he is able to actually grab this outpost under his control. Not going to stay in his control for very long unless he spams more infantry, which doesn't look like he's going to be able to in time. Neutralized outpost because of all of those Dillos and creeps that have come up. Now only with two Dillos in the area. Turtleton, oh, God, bringing a Dillo. Not what he needs. Needs to bring... Okay, well, not what he needed to at the time when this was still neutral. But this did go back up to blue, and he definitely will bring those two infantry in his build queue over here to this outpost. Will not get that far. Carnage with Death Ray, not using it, with a full bar of energy on the ground, almost finishing off Turtleton on the way back to that fort, or not fort, that outpost. However, Turtleton has been able to neutralize this outpost, but not dropping the soldiers properly on an open door. Probably this back door would have been the best decision, but now they are definitely being blocked. This will go, oh no, Carnage able to bring some creeps in time, either that or the creeps walked in. But now Turtleton just spamming soldiers, won't be able to, and again, the same thing from the last game. Seekers, and Turtleton falling victim to the Seekers this time! Not against the Warthog. Those Seekers were able to demolish that saucer. And, oh, when you get a kill, what you do? What do you do? Go attack the fort, sure. Carnage not using his Death Ray. Now will be finished off in the air by Turtleton on the way back. Oh, choices. Air Mech, ladies and gentlemen, is all about choices. I'm just going to leave it at that. You can infer what you would like to infer, but Turtleton. Now bring Adillo to the front door, landing right behind the Seeker. Not once again, decisions. And Carnage with 2 points into Death Ray. As a saucer, I would highly recommend to go either 1-1-1, Death Ray, Blink, and Abduct, because each of those abilities... are extremely amazing. So, obviously, at the higher levels of play, you can determine which ones are more important if you need to level them up. But as a newer player, I would highly recommend going 1-1-1 and using those abilities and figuring out how to use those abilities, especially if you are going with a saucer. Carnage coming with some jackals, but some of them are prioritizing that moneymaker. And Turtleton almost getting killed, but does save that moneymaker in time. This outpost will go down to neutral if Turtleton does not bring any more infantry. Does go down, but one creep will wander in. Carnage has a small surround with those jackals that were there. Let's see what he's going with. More jackals. Probably wanted to go with some infantry to keep this outpost neutral. Those creeps that are spawning right now will eventually be able to walk in. ZZI Carnage... those jackals spam are that's actually doing a pretty good job keeping this outpost neutral. However, they are not prioritizing on the outpost. They are kind of far, so this does go back up to Turtleton. Kind of hard to say Turtleton, to be honest, but I am saying it regardless. ZZI Carnage, gets that moneymaker before Turtleton's able to save it, or that Ratchet's able to save it and heal it up with that Death Ray, and able to come back to his outpost and survive that attack. Now coming with a single Dillo against, okay, that's definitely not probably what he should do. Now another Dillo coming over. No one has really fully committed to bottom yet either. Carnage started doing that at the beginning of the game, but definitely got a little bit distracted by Turtleton's harass and killing that Archie that he was going for the top. up top hasn't been touched as well. So this, I've once again never seen this before, but we do have a drop fight going from this outpost to this outpost over and over and over on Twin Peaks. Turtleton now starting to go more for the bottom. And let's see if he's actually successful in doing that. Carnage definitely not going to be scouting this out. I don't know if I should actually even talk about scouting and two-star Mavericks at the same time. It's sort of an oxymoron, to be honest, but I say it anyway, just because I want to imply that scouting is something that should happen. You really need to do that. However, the problem is using the scouting information. You know, if you see an outpost that's undefended, you really need to use that outpost or abuse that outpost or something like that, or maybe sneak attack it or something like that. I don't know. It's just speculation. If you see a nice open push path, you might want to go for that as well, something like that. A moneymaker that can be abducted. However, he doesn't have any points into abduct right now. Turtleton does have 1 point in each. Now just put a second point into Death Ray. And just, again, we just have a drop fest. Drop, drop, drop. And see here, I guess the problem here on Twin Peaks is each of these players are going, oh, look at the path toward the enemy fort here. So protected with neutrals, and the exact same thing this direction as well. So I think that's kind of one of the reasons why we aren't seeing any unit pushes or leapfrogs toward the neutrals. We're pretty much just seeing drops at, you know, enemy outposts. Turtleton has been able to clear his side of this bottom, and now bringing jokers for what is he... Did he bring jokers from here to here only to set them to move in this direction? but we do have a drop by Carnage here. It is a Dillo going for the fort. It was set on a tank. Thank God we do have a Joker Rush coming here by Turtleton. But Carnage with that Death Ray will be able to finish off these Jokers pretty quickly, especially with a few Dillos here at the fort to defend. However, it is allowing Turtleton to move and move. He was able to abduct this. And he's able to bring it back and putting it on a socket. That's pretty much exactly what he should have done in that situation. Maybe he needs to make a moneymaker for that socket, but in that specific situation at that time, dropping the T99 is something that I completely agree with. Turtleton now coming with more Dillos. This is probably not what he should do. There are a lot of defenses over here, but this one starting to abduct that T99, but instead going with the Death Ray to this Longhorn, getting himself killed. Probably shouldn't have done that in hindsight. I don't know. Maybe some of you guys would have been able to make that snap decision at that time, but for me, something that I had to have seen for myself, he died, therefore he shouldn't have done that. Air mech logic right there. If you died doing something, probably not worth doing unless it is front door hero hogging at the end of the game at overtime too. So now we do have Turtleton coming out here with some more Dillos. Again, just two. Okay, now four coming out, but needs to just drop them here. Okay, pick these up. Don't let them wander through. Pick these up. Don't abduct the ratchet. Why abduct the ratchet? You're going to die. Okay, so these other Dillos are going for the fort now because Turtleton did set them on attack instead of capture. Why he did that, only he knows. I guess because the T key is a little, or the Y key is, attack is better. I don't know. I was trying to make a joke there, but to be honest, I'm grasping for straws here because it's just something that I really would like to see new players know the difference between, attack and capture, and know that capture actually exists. A brute will be abducted by Turtleton if Carnage is not going to save it, but Turtleton's not abducting. He's instead losing the outpost. And Carnage with a Death Ray. God, Death Ray is so OP at mid the lower levels. Man, that's the reason that we see it so often. Just because it's so effective, DPS is really effective. Carnage able to grab this bottom outpost. Oh, Turtleton, you were so close in actually grabbing it. But now we actually do see a normal bottom fight here on Twin Peaks with each of the players having a pretty good unit cluster here at the bottom outposts. Creeps wandering and nobody going for... at all. Carnage, you had those Archies, you were going with them, but don't let Turtleton discourage you from doing that. Turtleton leapfrogging a little too far up. Those T-45s, not T-99s, but those T-45s actually are going to be, they were pretty much killed by those Dillos. However, these zippers at the back, I really like seeing this. Oh, brutes going down, so those zippers are pretty much null and void. Those brutes are going to demolish them extremely quickly. Turtleton trying to abduct them. Did he get it? No, he did not get that brute. It was so close, but I think that brute was killed, actually. It went in. It went into the outpost because it was bunkered. So definitely not a good thing. We do see Carnage here losing this outpost, but not enough. Definitely not enough. Creeps walking in. In the meantime, Turtleton did get killed. But where are you going with creeps? Bring creeps! Bring creeps! Retake the outpost! Retake the outpost! Don't just rely on the creeps to wander in. Grab the creeps! Retake the outpost! Oh god, I think I'm done. I think I need a 5-hour energy or something like that. Give me a Monster or a Red Bull. I really need something to make me last. Oh god, look at all these stacked infantry. Turtleton coming out here. These will pretty much be killed if they are not supported by anything. Turtleton not bring... An infantry rush will not work super well against Dillo. Turtleton, no! And now Carnage will be able to fire in with his death ray as well. Turtleton almost going down, getting finished off by those ground units following him to the air, and now Carnage gets pretty much a bunch of free experience. What does he have in his build queue right now? It is 45,000 credits in his and this lockbox. How much is in this lockbox right now? Turtleton, you gotta sell that lockbox. Doesn't have any goalies in his loadout, whereas Carnage definitely does. And some more brutes coming out on the field for Carnage. Does have them bunkered. So if those lights go down, they will walk in, and in this game mode, this is not salt. In this game mode, they definitely will be wasted if they just walk into the outpost. In the new salt map / game mode, oh god, another infantry rush, whatever, I'm gonna talk about salt, but yeah, in the new salt game mode, if you had brutes bunkered, they will walk into the outpost once the infantry / bulbs get knocked down, and they go into the infantry holes. So brutes bunkered in salt are really, really great. They kind of double their efforts by relighting the bulb and staying on the field as part of that outpost. But now we do have Turtleton with a Dillo push from the fort. He's starting a little far back. I don't know if that's 100% necessary, starting that far back, and he went all the way over here to drop a Dillo all the way over here when the fort was all the way over here. Okay, so whatever. And is he sending these on capture? Why are they all splitting? Okay, now resetting them on attack. And in the meantime, let's see what Carnage is doing using that death ray. Why isn't the Ratchet healing this? Okay, the Ratchet took a little bit of time to start healing that that T-45. The T-45 was killed in the process. Oh, Carnage getting finished off before it gets back to that outpost at the bottom. And these Dillos are actually going to be pretty awesome. Some of them do stop here. And Turtleton coming in with more. You need to start either abducting or death raying. Probably death raying behind the Dillos would be the most effective thing right now, but Carnage is back here at the fight to death ray into the Dillos of Turtleton, and Turtleton getting finished off by all those Seekers. Seeker spam, pretty effective on smaller maps, definitely here on Twin Peaks. That last game on Chasm, Carnage's Seeker spam wasn't that effective, especially because he was putting them next to friendly or enemy outposts instead of friendly outposts. But now with more brutes coming out, he could definitely push. Just take a quick scout over here. Come on, Carnage. Scout the other outpost. No, don't just sit there. You don't even know what's over there. If you could look at what's over there, you could make an educated decision and guess. I guess would be better than nothing. So he's just death raying creeps. Okay, guys, newbies watching Two Star Mavericks. Death raying creeps, not a productive use of your time. Please stop doing it. Please stop doing it. Please stop doing it. Carnage. Okay, all the brutes are on the field. Look at what Turtleton has over here. I don't care if you can process the information. Just take a look. Just take a quick gander over there. Come on, please. Are you gonna look? No, just death ray. Okay, now you can see. Come on, you can see. You can see there's not really anything over there, but he's just really, really scared to move out, and that's, I guess, one of the problems. Maybe we need to put a pushing challenge or something in the challenge mats. Carnage getting finished off there, staying on the ground way too long with that death ray. I think actually did that light mine finish him off. I don't know, I was too busy tripping right now. And now Turtleton actually starting a move for the top, starting leapfrog and stuff. Has zippers, not really necessary here, just needs more DPS dealing stuff. That ratchet will disarm that mine. Instead of healing up those Dillos, is it, okay, they are starting to reprioritize, but now Carnage is finally starting to move out just with the brutes. Look at all the other units over here, and he's only moving out with like a couple brutes. Need to go out with more Carnage. Carnage, neutralize the outposts. Prioritize on the neutralization. If Turtleton doesn't have an outpost in the area, he's screwed, but instead he's going to be able to abduct these brutes. Oh God, able to drop one of the roots over here. They will not walk in because they can take command, so they pretty much are going to be on hold position or on capture. I'm not exactly sure, but now Carnage will be able to bring more seekers. Oh, I should not start my phrases before I know what I'm gonna say. Will be able to bring more seekers is not something that I really should encourage at this point. Send more units. Send all your look. God, look, look, just look. Take a look. Carnage. No, come on, man. Stop bringing things over one at a time. You can push. Units can receive commands. Please, God, use the commands. Turtleton is doing a pretty marvelous job clearing the units up here at the top, and if he gets that, he will be at a humongous advantage with more power, more map control, and Carnage, you have the 130 to 77 upkeep. Oh, I'm going to lose my voice. 130 to 81, 133 to 70 right now. Turtleton grabbing top. Carnage moving out with one Dillo. Oh, no, there was a second one. Okay, so I can't fault him 100% for that, so there were two Dillos moving out there. Booty moved out with two Dillos. Oh God, okay, so now all these brutes are gonna just, I mean, okay, Turtleton sending a bunch of crap in, sending a bunch of infantry into brutes, so, and infantry that are not brutes into brutes, so now Carnage will be able to move out with these brutes, but just needs to use more than that. Carnage, you have more than just brutes right now. I think the brutes will do the job at this point, and now that Seeker pretty much doing nothing but being a meat shield at this point, because Turtleton is definitely not really in danger of dying from it. And the T99 coming out, another T99 coming out, but all these brutes are pretty much going to wreak havoc. Carnage, don't die, please don't die. Yes, gets back to the outpost before he dies. And Turtleton having a really hard time dealing with all these brutes, but the brutes could be abducted. I guess not really that really productive use of his time. That one brute that was abducted will die. The brutes will walk into this outpost. T99 going down, so Turtleton losing bottom, grabbing top before losing bottom, though, so he definitely is still in the game. Carnage will be able to turtle this up with Seekers. Oh God, once again, turtling up with Seekers. Okay, so, but still has the brutes, so the brutes are definitely good enough. Come on, Carnage, look, once again, come on, man, and over here, please, no, Turtleton's able to retake this outpost. I'm hyperventilating. Okay, so Carnage, with so many Seekers. Seekers are not getting you anywhere, man. Stop bringing Seekers to the enemy outpost. They're not going to be able to, and if you do, stop putting them so damn close. Sometimes they do get blocked. Carnage needs to move out. He has this game won, but he doesn't know it. It's a 115 to 60 upkeep difference. He has pretty much double the upkeep as Turtleton, and he's not using the units that he needs to use. RUI falsetto right there, guys. That was just, it's just driving me nuts. I am going pirate mode. Carnage going with the death ray once again, so this is going to work fairly well, but not that well. Carnage, use your units. Stop spamming Seekers! Stop spamming Seekers! You can't hear me. Someone whisper to this guy. This game is probably in the middle, but someone whisper to this guy. ZZI Carnage, ZZ, stop spamming Seekers. Use your ground units. Use your Dillos. Queue up. Oh, thank God, he's finally queuing up Goliaths. But stop spamming Seekers. If you're going to spam Seekers, use them all at the same time. You have enough to focus this guy over his outpost, but now Turtleton getting followed by all those Seeker missiles and didn't have a chance to use that death ray. I don't know if you guys heard that, but he was starting to use his death ray, didn't get to actually use it, and retreated just in time. I do applaud him for that. I don't know if he used Blink to get out of there, but did retreat in time, did not get himself killed, did not overcommit on his random decision to do a side door moneymaker attack. And Carnage... attacking the ratchet at the fort. Once again, I'm gonna just say the word decisions, okay? You guys can draw whatever conclusions you'd like from that, but decisions, okay? There is a big fight there down at the bottom. Carnage getting killed in the air, doesn't use Blink at all. I think he might have been out of energy, but... okay, one Archie. Oh, he did do what I said before, put that Archie up and killing Turtleton in the air. Well, let's see if there's any AA to support him. Yes, there was a bunch of Seekers there, so Turtleton probably should have just blinked the hell out of there. That lockbox, Carnage, lockbox. Yes, get the lockbox. Turtleton not able to save the lockbox, so ladies and gentlemen, we will never know how much that lockbox was worth. Unfortunately, I really actually did want to know how much that lockbox is worth. However, he is not going to be able to sell that off after he gets killed. So now we do have a couple of Goliaths out on the field for Carnage. This is pretty much going to be the turning point in the game. If he just continues to spam these Goliaths, the T-45s that Turtleton is bringing out on the field are definitely going to be not going to be a match for those Goliaths, unless Carnage just continually spams Seekers instead of Goliaths, which I wouldn't be surprised if it happens. But if he does, then Turtleton might have a chance. But I really, really hope to see Carnage coming out with more goalies to make up for that loss from last game. Carnage getting kill on the ground. Mostly the DPS came from that death ray, but getting finished off by creeps, I'm pretty sure that was. And now Turtleton, that is very dangerous. So I guess, yes, against the Seeker, against the Saucer, the Seeker spam is kind of effective. But in a 1v1, doesn't need that many, to be honest. However, more... Okay, Goliaths out on the field. Put a Moneymaker right here. You'll be better off in a much better off position, but whatever. Turtleton not putting down more Moneymakers as well, even though he does have that top. Carnage, yes, now refocusing his fight, probably where he should there at the bottom. And Turtleton now also going with the top. And Abduct, okay, nope, not going to work. Okay. I thought he was going to be killed by those following Seeker missiles, which I love seeing, by the way. It's pretty darn hilarious when people get followed by Seeker missiles and get killed over their outpost. I know you guys love seeing it too, don't lie. It is pretty awesome and hilarious to see. But now Turtleton queuing up more Dillos, which will pretty much do absolutely nothing against these Goliaths that Carnage has coming out on the field. Does have a Seeker in socketed position. Oh my god, does he have two Seekers? Oh no, there's one Seeker in socketed right there. Carnage needs to put down a Moneymaker, but hey, Moneymakers are OP, and maybe he's one of those players that are like, if a unit is too OP, I'm not going to use it because I don't want to be like one of those guys. Turtleton, however, will get that Moneymaker killed, and now Carnage dropping. He has a million Dillos and Seekers sitting over here by his fort. Decides to bring out a Goliath to defend against a Saucer out on the field. So that's not necessarily something that I would recommend. I really, really want to see that. So a Seeker killing people over outposts, freaking hilarious. Now coming with two Dillos, Carnage able to block one with the Goliath. No, neither of them are blocked, so a lot of damage going down on Carnage right now. Turtleton might actually be able to take this win away from Carnage by just Dillo dropping over and over again. Carnage might actually be able to wall up with Seekers. Wall up with Seekers. Again, another phrase that I've never said before. Wall up with Seekers. OP. Carnage will never be susceptible to a death ray attack again on the fort. But wall up with Seekers. That is definitely... Okay, now Carnage getting finished off there by Turtleton in the air, trying to tango with those creeps, level 4 creeps on the ground. Turtleton with a bunch of Dillos coming out. I do think this is going to be in Turtleton's favor, getting finished off by those Seekers, but those Dillos, one of them is penetrating. Another one is going to be able to finish off that Seeker if it doesn't get contested by this Goliath enough. But ZZI Carnage, oh god, instead of going for the front door attack or the side door, he's just going for sockets and going to kill the Zipper, because the Zipper is definitely the number one threat right now, instead of the mech, the Jokers that just got dropped, putting in damage. None of those are probably priority over the Zipper, right? Because the Zipper, you can bunker Zippers. God, bunker Zippers are also pretty amazing. Oh, Carnage getting killed by Turtleton on the way out. Most of the damage coming in, most of the damage getting put on the way in. And now Turtleton, actually, look at that blue trail behind the Saucer. That actually looks pretty cool, man. If we can get that accentuated, because that's not a contrail, but I do really like that. That really does look pretty cool. And now let's see what's coming out. ZZI Carnage queuing up Dillos instead of more Goliaths. I don't know at this point. We are finally into overtime, too, so this game will, thank God, end eventually. Brute going down. Oh, not a Brute going down. A Brute getting abducted by Turtleton. Carnage going to be able to finish that off with his death ray. And Turtleton with more... Yes, open front door! Getting those two Dillos out on the front door. So let's see how much damage that it does put down. Only three Dillos to contest it, so they will get a fair amount of time to actually fire in here. Finally now getting finished off. Yes, just now. Carnage with a Goliath dropping it at the outpost instead of the front door, which is only defended by light units, so that Goliath would have been pretty amazing. Turtleton probably going to be able to abduct this. No, Carnage picking it up, but running out of energy soon, so... Turtleton will be able to abduct this now. He does finally have a Goliath under his... Oh, my God. Carnage getting killed. That outpost not under his control. And Turtleton now dropping that Goliath. Oh, and does reset the command to hold position. So that's definitely not a noob right there. We do know that he does know how to, you know, if something gets abducted, you know, everybody does it. Even I do it. Even top-tier players do it. Sometimes you do just forget to recommand it. Oh, and able to drop this Goliath. Okay, oh, my God. Nothing over here contesting. There's no more ground attacking units over here. ZZI Carnage is moving out, so that Goliath is completely uncontested on the front door. Oh my God, Carnage! Carnage is gonna go down once again to this Goliath! He moved out pretty much at the worst time ever, when a single Goliath was dropped at his fort. No, and instead of body blocking it... Oh God, instead of body blocking it, instead of trying to move a seeker out of the way right when he's about to die. Oh God, okay. He starts to abduct it. Oh God, he started to abduct it right at the end there. Oh God. Okay, guys, I'm done. If I do any more, I think I'm gonna collapse. Oh, Lord. Oh, okay. I'm so lightheaded right now, guys. Okay, I'm gonna do a closing just for my YouTube. So, if you guys want to send in 2-star Maverick replays to me, I will accept 2 and 1-star one-star games. ELO-rated game, please make sure to note what rank, was it 1-star or 2-star, in your submission to me. And I will award you with a donut code, one of these, it's still in my search. You will be able to get a donut code if you can give me a usable, pretty darn funny 2-star Mavericks replay. So check my video description for that to find out details and to sending it in to me. Pretty much just send it into RUI0x@gmail.com or RUI on Steam. And Stuart is giving me a friend request, so why the hell not? Just don't spam party requests to me over and over again. That would be great. So once again, guys, this is RUI, and that is game. See you next time. And cut. So, guys, Turtleton is playing again. Oh, Jesus. What is happening in chat? 2-star Mavericks. Dude, Thai, if you want to do 2-star Mavericks R-rated version, that would be pretty... I am completely fine with that, man. That would be pretty damn hilarious. But yeah, guys, I think I'm done. My voice is shot. I'm out of breath. I probably need to eat food or at least eat some sugar or some stuff. Take a quick drink of water real quick. Oh, my God. Okay, so, I don't really stream that much, guys. If you guys want to check out other Aramex streams, Thai Tombstone has come back into the scene after a pretty short or long, I'm not really sure how to define it, but after a hiatus, I know he was pretty busy in real life, so Thai Tombstone here in chat, okay, he does say he is going live, so guys, check out his stream coming up. Just click on his name, or if you want to drop your link in, that is completely fine, because I'm pretty much done. Also check out Steve0324. Actually, I'm going to link to the community schedule right now. Where is that? Okay, thanks. Bonjibon is going to be able to do that. That is the Aramex community schedule. It has all the different Aramex streamers. Right now, though, Thy Tombstone is coming up, and Bonjibon apparently said that is the wrong link, so that's great. So don't click that one have the impression that what I was talking about is going to go on it. But yes, so there is an Aramex community schedule, which Bonjibon will eventually put onto stream. However, Thy Tombstone is going to go live right now, so be sure to support his stream as well. Definitely support as many Aramex streams, videos, check out the forums, you know, third-party websites, whatever you can. Aramex really, really needs to grow, guys. Everyone can see its potential. All of the Aramex vets can see its potential. It is definitely in changing / balancing / developing phase right now, as you can see in the salt mode. So if you can give Aramex as much support as you can, tell your friends, get referrals, you will get diamonds. That would make me probably pretty happy, just because I want to see Aramex succeed as much as possible. More programmers would be great if they can afford that. That would be great, and they can afford that if we can get more players into the game, buying more booster packs, and I don't know. I don't know how to plug Aramech anymore. I just this game is pretty awesome. It's a one of a kind thing. Everyone can see it. You guys can see it too. Let's just hope everyone else can see it as well. So, all right, guys. That I'm gonna say it one more time. This is our UI. That is game. I'm gonna turn my music right back on. Copyrighted music. OP. See you next time. Okay, so I've been informed that my music is not actually on. I haven't changed anything in my stupid Twitch settings. You know what? I'm just going to add Winamp. What the hell? Click. There we are. All right, guys. Can you hear music now? I absolutely hate this. It's there just really quiet. Okay. I'm going to turn it kind of up. So I'm going to go offline in a few minutes. Everybody, please be sure to check on Thy Tombstone's stream, which is going up pretty much right now. See you guys later.